Hi everyone, happy Monday. It's a warm and a little bit windy day here in California. Hopefully the wind doesn't kick up. I've got an umbrella over me, so I'm staying nice and cool. Camera guy's inside filling seed orders, so I'm out here all by myself today except for Mac. So happy Monday, hope you guys had a great weekend. I don't know about you guys, but we got a ton of garden work done yesterday. We actually took the whole weekend off. We were able to film our weekend video on Friday. Thanks to those of you who joined us for the premiere first thing Saturday morning. It was great to see a lot of you online. We got to watch the video together. It was a ton of fun. And then we really enjoyed a lot of garden work this weekend. I'm gonna turn the camera around so you can see the hill here. I actually pulled out a lot of things yesterday. The nasturtiums are really taking a beating from the heat we've had. So I was able to thin out all the plants on the hill and get a lot of new vegetables planted. We've got some shade cloth up to protect the new seedlings. And it is gonna be a hot one again this week. I know a lot of people are still in the cold, in the snow. I was just texting Gary at the Rustic Garden this morning and he said they're getting a frost this week in Maryland. So I don't know if Jack is on here from Maryland. We're gonna be in the 90s this week, so it is kind of crazy. So today our topic is 3 tips to grow a lot of beans. Beans are such an easy vegetable to grow. If you haven't grown them yet, we're gonna talk all about it today. And but before we do that, I wanna see who's here. A lot of people are in the chat early to say hello. So thanks so much for taking time out of your Monday to join me. And let's see who's here today. My phone keeps dimming because I guess maybe because it's getting too hot. I don't know. So it's kind of hard to see right now. So I'll do my best. Sister Marcel is here and she mentioned earlier in the chat that she hasn't been able to join us for a while. So welcome back. So glad you're here today. And let's see, little Elena. Hello, how are you? Tiffany is here. Pia, hi Pia, how are you doing? Irene. Rod from Baja. Wow, so great to see. I know the Healing Berry Garden is here from Germany. Ollie is here from Germany as well. So it's really fun to have an international audience. People here from all over the world to learn about growing vegetables. And welcome to all the first time live streamers as well. If you're here for the first time joining us, we live stream every Monday at noon Pacific time. And then during the pandemic, we've also been doing a Friday fireside at 5:30 p.m. More of a casual kind of get together, hang out, see how our week has been. So make sure you join us on Mondays and Fridays. Loretta Jones from Fairfax, Virginia and Ocean View, Delaware. Welcome. So glad you're here. If you're a first-time live streamer or a first-time gardener, please let me know. Marissa Thompson, growing Chinese yard long beans. Wow, I have never grown the yard long beans. That would be really fun to try because I've seen some really cool pictures of those on Instagram. So let's see. Let's jump right into our bean basics. What I'm going to do, if you're new on the live stream, how we work it is, I share some information. Today we're talking about beans, so I'll share some bean basics. Then I'll come back into the chat and see who has questions. Then I'll go back and share the 3 tips for growing lots and lots of beans. So I've got some beautiful beans right behind me here. These are the Scarlet Runner beans. If you saw any of our videos last year or even saw my Instagram post this morning, I posted a couple of pictures of some Scarlet Runner beans from last year. And I'm gonna show you the beautiful, beautiful seeds, probably one of the most beautiful seeds ever. I'll show you those in just a moment. But for now, I wanna share some bean basics. Beans are one of the easiest vegetables to grow. If you're a first-time gardener, then you are in the right place because you're gonna learn all about growing beans today. And it's a great crop to start with, especially good to grow with kids because they sprout so, so fast. In fact, I just started some indoors. You can start them from seed indoors if you like, which I like to do to get them off to a fast start. And these are some little cups with soil. And I put some bean seeds in here about 2 weeks ago and they're growing absolutely crazy already. Your kids are gonna love seeing them sprout. Give them their own little container. Give them their own little cup of beans. Bean seeds, let them plant them and they're gonna absolutely love it. I'm actually getting ready for the container garden series, which will be starting hopefully in about 2 weeks. So I'm starting a bunch of seeds to get ready for that. And these are very, very fun. So you can start them from seed indoors. They're a warm weather vegetable. So they really love temperatures between 50 and 85 degrees. So if you're still expecting a frost where you live, you may want to hold off on planting beans because they are very cold sensitive. You want to plant them outdoors. You can also direct seed them right in your garden a couple of weeks after your last frost date because they do like very warm soil. Start them indoors a few weeks before your last frost, outdoors directly in the garden a few weeks after your last frost date. And I want to show you some of the seeds that I have here. There's so many different wonderful varieties of beans. There's bush beans, which grow in a bushy kind of way. And there's pole beans, which I mentioned I have growing right behind me. And I have a bean seed collection if you need some bean seeds. This is available on our website, calicumgardenandhome.com. Five varieties in there. And let me show you some of these beautiful, beautiful seeds. These are the slenderette bush beans. So these are seeds that are the beans that are a little bit smaller in size, so especially good for containers, although just about any type of bush bean you can grow in a container. But this is one of my favorite kind. They're really tender and tasty. They're called slenderette. And here's another one. This is a beautiful bean called Royal Burgundy. They're a purple bean, have beautiful purple flowers. You guys are gonna love growing Royal Burgundy, especially look pretty with my the Cali Kim Purple Smart Pots. A lot of you have that and are growing in that. And it just makes a really fun, nice color splash. So why not have some beautiful colors in your garden? This is another favorite called Golden Wax. They're a nice yellow bean, so it's really fun to have those. And then there's another one in here. What is this one? Oh, the Kentucky Wonder Bean. This actually is a bush bean and a pole bean. There's two separate varieties. This particular one is the bush bean, but I also have some of the pole beans growing right behind me here. And then I've got to show you my all-time favorite seed. I've got to take these out because these are so beautiful. These are the Scarlet Runner beans and probably one of my very favorite varieties. I mean, if you guys are a seed addict, you have got to grow these, if not just for the seed. So grab the bean seed collection so you can see how beautiful these are. I'm going to go ahead and take them out of the packet because these are just incredible. They're purple and black. And can you guys see how beautiful those are? They're very large beans because they're very large seeds because they grow into very, very large beans. There's some growing right behind me here. They're gonna grow up and over this trellis. So go over and look at my Instagram photo. I posted one of these on my story this morning, actually, of the trellis from last summer with these beautiful Scarlet Runner beans. They are just amazing. The beans themselves need to be picked when they're quite young, maybe 4 inches or so long, maybe 6 inches, but they're so tender and so tasty. And then you can let the beans grow larger if you want to, and then harvest them for the bean seeds themselves. And then you can actually, the beans will dry on the pot if you leave them on the plant long enough. And then you can cook them up just like you would refried beans. I have actually a whole jar I've saved from last year that I got to do that. I keep meaning to cook them up and try them like in a burrito or something. I mean, how cool is that? You can grow beans like that right in your own garden. So before we get into the tips, I want to show you a little container of beans I have growing right over here. I've got to move my camera. It's windy, so I have everything kind of anchored down. But yeah, they grow beautifully in a container. I have some growing in a purple smart pots right over there. I don't know if you guys can see that. It's hard for me to see what you're looking at, but that's a quite a large size purple smart pots. I think it's about a 13 square foot size. Got some bush beans growing in there, but you can also grow them in a smaller container. I've got one of the Cali Kim smart pots right here with some kale in it. This is a 5-gallon container, and you can grow it in that size container as well. Or you can just direct seed them right in your garden bed. Sorry to move the camera around on you guys. Like I said, everything's anchored down, so it's a little bit awkward to move it. Containers in ground, such a versatile vegetable. You can expect to harvest beans as long as it's around, you know, between 60 and 85 degrees. You can plant the seeds and expect to harvest them in about 6 weeks. So that's what's so cool. They produce a lot. They grow quick. It's going to give you some food to eat of your own during this crazy time when you're not going to want to get to the grocery store. So get some bean seeds planted. You are going to be so glad you did. So let me head into the chat, see if we have any questions, and then we'll jump into sharing the tips for how to grow a lot of beans. Okay, here we go, guys. Pia Butler, from your bean seed collection, which ones have edible pods? They all do, Pia. That's the great thing about beans is you can, throw them, you can boil them in water. Sometimes I throw them on the barbecue. Sometimes I'll even bake them in the oven, but they all have edible pods. Now, we're going to talk a little bit more later in the live stream about harvesting. So that's really the key to the pods being edible, especially the scarlet runner beans, is harvesting. Max rolling around and knocking into my tripod here, is harvesting them when they're young. So we'll talk about that in just a few minutes. And I see a lot of questions flying by that we're also going to answer. What type of fertilizer do they need? We're going to talk about that as well. Do beans have deep roots, from James? Hi, James. How are you doing today? Great to have you on here. Oh, I see a couple questions about that. Nicole, James, I'm not sure who asked that question. But no, they don't have super deep roots. They're not like tomatoes or watermelon or something like that. So that's one reason why they do grow very well in a container, even a smaller size container like the Calichem Smart Pots. Or they could probably even go, well, I probably wouldn't do much smaller than a 5 gallon, because you're going to need several plants, and you could probably fit maybe 5 or 6 plants in the 5 gallon here. And I saw a super chat here from Tiffany. Thank you so much, Tiffany, for $9.99 super chat. Really appreciate it. And your question is, do bush beans produce less than the runner beans? Tiffany, I would say the runner beans are so large. So yeah, that's one reason why they're super productive, but they do take up more space. So you kind of have to gauge the pros and cons of that. So yeah, I would say the bush beans do produce less, just because they're smaller plants, pretty much like anything else. So look at the space you have and then plant accordingly. So if you want more information on the runner beans, I think I popped a couple links in the video description. Once the video uploads that you can see, or just search my YouTube channel for beans and you're going to see a couple videos on the runner beans that I have right behind me here from last summer. So believe it or not, these grew back from last year. When I cut them out, I just cut them off at the base, left the beans in, and these are regrowing from last year, which supposedly I tried that for the first time. It's working here in California. I'm not sure how it works in colder climates on the runner beans. So if anyone has any experience with that, then please let me know. Okay, one more question and let's move on. Then we'll move on to our first tip. And the question is from Alini. Hi, Alini. Can I start my seeds in peat pellets? You absolutely can. You can start them in the peat pellets. I've done that a million times. You can start them in these little cups with soil. I wouldn't recommend, though, the small peat pellets. You definitely want to find the large ones if you can, or just find a couple little containers around your house, like those old yogurt or sour cream containers, or even a cup. Make sure there's holes in the bottom, and then pop some bean seeds in there. It's a good way to get them off to a fast start, especially if it's not quite warm enough yet to get them out in the garden. Oh, and before I forget, guys, I made a post on Instagram. I just realized that Sunday, this coming Sunday, is Mother's Day. So I wanted to get a post out to let you guys know that a really great personal gift for your mom or your wife or your significant other woman in your life who is a mom would be a signed copy of my book. And I will personalize it to the person that you purchase it for your mom or for your wife. I'll personalize it with her name. And you, when you grab seeds on my website, or the Spring Garden Seed Collection, it's in a bundle on my website, and you can save $5. So you can go over to CallieKimGardenHome.com, grab this for your mom, I'll personalize it for her. I even had one of our viewers, Rory, send me a personal message for her mom. She emailed it to me, and I'm going to print that out and then include that with the order. So great personal gift for your mom to help encourage her to garden. But you have to order it today. Today, if you want it to get there, for the best chance of it getting there, at least in the U.S. by Mother's Day. Canada, I just shipped to U.S. and Canada, so Canada will definitely take a bit longer. But if you order today, it will ship out, and fingers crossed, it will get there in time for Mother's Day. But the mail service is a little bit slow these days, so we'll do the best we can. Okay, let's head into our very first tip here to growing lots of beans. And I wanted to mention, there is a lot of details in here about growing beans, a lot more than we can cover here in this live stream. So this is a great garden how-to manual to take out in the garden with you to know how to plant the basic warm weather and cool weather vegetables. All right, so first tip here on growing lots of beans. And if you want to grow a lot of beans, make sure that you plant them all season long. It's not just a one and done crop. You can plant beans every two to three weeks. And that way, once one crop is finished producing and starting to die out, you're going to have another crop of beans coming in its place and ready to harvest. So the goal for us as gardeners is always have something to harvest from your garden. Especially now, you want to minimize those trips to the grocery store as much as possible. And beans is a real power producer. It will produce a lot of vegetables for you. You probably want to figure maybe 2 to 3 plants per person in your family to give you enough. But that method of planting every 2 to 3 weeks, for those of you that are new to gardening, is called succession planting. So even if you just have a couple little containers, like the 5-gallon here, plant some in there, and then save yourself another little container, set it aside, or another little spot in your garden to plant some more seeds in a couple of weeks. So that spreads your harvest out so you don't have tons of beans all at once. And that way you're gonna have beans all summer long. So, you know, if you're already past your frost date, get some planted in your garden beds. And then a few weeks later, plant some in a container. Maybe you wanna try a couple different varieties from the bean seed collection. If you have room for a big tall trellis, you can plant the runner beans and the pole beans. And it's really gonna be a lot of fun to see them grow. They grow so fast and to have those delicious beans to harvest. So it's called succession planting. First tip for growing a lot of beans: plant beans all summer long. You can plant them up until, so that they mature up until they mature before the first frost of the fall. So back up, like if your first frost is in October, you want to get your last crop maybe planted in August to give yourself enough time to get them harvested before the frost hits. So plant beans all summer long and you're going to be eating delicious, yummy beans before you know it. Okay, let's head into the chat here, see what questions there are. Let me see if I forgot anything to include. Oh, I do have a video on succession planting. Like I mentioned, that's what this method is called. So you can head over to my channel and look up succession planting, and you'll see some tips on some other vegetables you can also succession plant to spread your harvest out throughout the warm weather months. So let's head into the chat here, see what questions are going on. Here's a question from Ruby. Hi, Ruby. How are you doing today? I live in central Texas. Temperatures get in the hundreds. Will my beans die in direct sun? Should I place a shade tarp? Love your videos. Thank you so much, Ruby. Appreciate that. And I highly recommend shade cloth. We get so hot here, Ruby. It's supposed to be close to 100 this week. And whenever the temperatures, say 85 in the 90 degree range or hotter, I get my shade cloth out because most vegetables do not produce well in temperatures over 85, 90-ish degrees. So yes, I would definitely get your shade cloth out, get it ready. And in fact, beans don't produce well over 80, 85. They just don't grow the flowers and all that. So yeah, get your shade cloth out. Go back and watch the two videos we did a few weeks ago on the early heat wave that we had. It'll show you exactly what to do. Keep it simple, even use old sheets or sheer curtains and get ready for that. Okay, let's see who else has tips in the chat. Do these tips apply to peas too? Some do, some don't. I have a lot of other videos on peas. Peas are a cool weather vegetable, so they're not gonna do well in the heat of the summer. In fact, a lot of my peas are starting to die out because of our heat. We get early heat here in California. A lot of you that are in the springtime and it's cooler temperatures under 75 are probably able to grow peas right now. Start your peas and then harvest them before the weather gets over 75 degrees or so. Okay, hi Nisha. Your question is, how close can you plant beans in a 10-gallon container? Good question, Nisha. I actually meant to mention that earlier, how close together you can plant them. I would plant them, the smaller varieties, like, well, just pretty much any regular variety of bean, not the pole beans, like these little royal burgundies. You wanna plant them about 2 inches apart or so in a container. And really that's fine. They don't mind touching each other. You don't want them to plant them just an inch apart. If a lot of them come up that you didn't expect, you can even very carefully dig them up or snip them off at root level or dig them up and transplant them into a new container. They don't really like to have their roots disturbed much. So, you know, it's kind of a, you can, that's a toss up with that if they'll actually transplant, but give it a try. Always fun to experiment. So a 10 gallon container, you should be able to fit, depending on how large your container is, around or long your container is, you should be able to fit a good amount of beans in there. Probably enough for you and your husband, Nisha, but again, plant them every couple of weeks. Okay, other questions about beans? You're welcome, Nisha. Danny, how are you? And Danny says, hi, my mom and I love your channel. Thank you so much. We planted our squashes, peppers, and zucchini outside yesterday. We live in zone 6B. How can we save them if it gets too cold? Okay, great question, Danny. You will definitely want to have some kind of cover hanging around just in case you have those nights where it's going to dip down. Hopefully you're not expecting a frost, but we don't get frost here, but I know what a lot of people do when they're expecting frost is they get like a storage tub, those big storage tubs you can get from Target. Maybe you have a cardboard box around your house, even an old quilt or blanket, and I would drape it over your plants, maybe put a couple stakes in the ground, and that should help protect it. No guarantees though, if you get a frost, that you won't get some frost damage, but that definitely should help protect it. So you know what? Make sure that you start backups though, so that if something does happen, you have some plants going indoors in case you do lose some, because we always have to be prepared. Things are going to happen. We are going to have challenges in the garden at some point. Oops, did I miss a super chat? Let me scroll back through. Thank you, Cliff. Oh, Stephanie Hickson. Hi, how are you? $24.99. Thank you so much, Stephanie. Oh, that is so nice. I really appreciate it. Appreciate you showing us your support. And I really appreciate you being here. And Stephanie says thank you. And you're very, very welcome. Okay. Jack. Hi, Jack. How are you today? Mine is only 4 feet. Couldn't get any cattle panel. Oh, I think you're talking to Cliff there. All right. Sorry about that. Okay, Alicia York, where do you buy your beans? Well, you can buy them from me, actually. I have beans on my website, a bean seed collection, which I showed a little bit earlier, CallieKimGardenAndHome.com, so you can grab yourself 5 varieties in here and get yourself some beans planted. All right, let's go into our second tip here. All right, tip one was plant beans all summer long. Tip two, and a lot of you were asking about this a little bit earlier, is water regularly and don't over fertilize. Now, a lot of the other vegetables that we've talked about in the past few live streams, like peppers and tomatoes, do need regular fertilizing. Beans are not one of them. You do need to water regularly, though, of course. You don't want them to dry out. If your beans dry out, they're not going to produce the flowers that they need to produce the beans. So please, if you're growing in containers, make sure that you have your containers on a regular watering system. Check them daily if you're watering by hand. Don't let your containers dry out, because when they dry out, when they completely dry out, the soil completely dries out, it's a lot harder to moisten that up again. But especially with beans, they're not gonna produce flowers if they're dry, and it could really stunt the plants and you might not get as much growth out of them. So make sure that you are very diligent about checking your bean plants for water, especially in this kind of heat that we're having here and the wind. Okay, as far as fertilizing goes, they don't need a lot of fertilizer because beans do something that's called fixed nitrogen in the soil. And I won't go into what all that means, but basically it means that they help build nitrogen, which is the component that helps your plants be nice and green and leafy. So they already kind of produce their own fertilizer. So what I do is I just add some fertilizer at the time of planting. I'll put compost in my soil. I will do like a mild fertilizer, like the Vermistera worm tea is very mild and it just keeps your plants healthy, keeps them producing. So I may do that maybe once or twice, like maybe once a month or so if I'm in containers. But you don't need a high nitrogen fertilizer on beans like the fish fertilizer or the good dirt fertilizer. Just use something very mild like the worm tea just to keep them healthy, keep them producing. But usually they do very, very well without any fertilizer at all. Just make sure your soil is really rich at the time that you plant them. So that's going to help you produce a lot of beans, because when you over fertilize your plants, not only does it kind of stunt their growth, we're over-loving them, but with beans, that's going to cause you to grow tons of green leaves rather than the actual beans themselves. So easy does it on the fertilizer, and you're going to grow a lot of beans. So tip one, make sure that you plant them all summer long. Tip two, water regularly, but don't over-fertilize. So let me see if there's any other items that I need to mention on that here. I think we're good on the tip number two. So let's take a look at the chat here, see what questions you have about beans. I see a question here from Megan. Would scarlet runner beans be a good choice for a screen, block out the neighbors? Also, do I need to inoculate the seeds? Yes, scarlet runner beans are wonderful for that. I don't know if you guys can see this cattle panel, probably not so much, but this is a cattle panel made into an archway. But again, go back and watch our videos for a full look at that, and check my Instagram out for a full look of how tall they get. And you'll see that, yes, they're very good for a privacy screen. You'll need to have a very tall trellis. I've tried to grow them on a short trellis before, and they just didn't do well. They didn't have enough space. So get yourself a tall trellis. There's plenty of ideas over on our YouTube channel on how to do that. Okay, what pH, A-Gord? What pH soil do beans prefer? You know, A-Gord, I keep things really simple around here, and I really have not done too much on pH. I just make sure that my soil is well amended with compost and fertilized regularly, and I really haven't worried too much about the pH. So if that's something that you're interested in, you'll definitely want to do some more research on that. Okay, let's see here. Are pinto beans bush beans or pole beans? Angela, I myself have never grown pinto beans. I believe that they are bush beans, but it could possibly be there's a pole bean variety out there. If someone knows about that, pop it in the chat there. This is what I love about this community, is we all learn from each other. So that makes it really fun. Okay, Missouri girl, how are you doing today? Great to see you on here. What all can I do with beans? Okay, that's a great question, because a lot of people grow their vegetables and then they don't know what to do with them. So there's a lot of different things you can do with beans. We pretty much just eat them, you know, fresh. I boil them on the stove. I'll bake them in the oven. I'll do a big vegetable kind of bake in the oven and throw the beans in there. Sometimes we'll throw them on a grill. You can make pickled beans. My mom used to make those all the time when we were little, pickled green beans, and then can them. And we'd have them all winter. I don't know how to make those, but I'm sure there's a lot of great recipes out there. But we pretty much just eat them fresh and eat them with our meals. I know that you can freeze them. I usually just will blanch them in boiling water for maybe 2 or 3 minutes, I think, but you'd have to look that up for sure, and then throw them in freezer bags. Then you can pull them out during the winter time, and it's so much fun to pull out those tasty veggies when it's too cold to grow them outside. And beans are one of those that do produce a lot, so you may need to do some freezing or canning. And thank you, Megan, for the super chat of $4.99. Can't wait for the new container garden series. Thank you so much. We're really looking forward to that too. Happy early Mother's Day. Thank you so much, Megan. I appreciate that. And if you're a mother, happy Mother's Day to you too. I hope you have a special day. And it's kind of crazy to think it's already May, right? It just, I don't know, that you kind of lose track of time during this whole stay at home thing. I've really like, hey, what day is it today? What date is it? What month are we in? I don't know if you guys are dealing with that too, but it's just kind of one of those weird times. So thank you so much, Samantha. I appreciate that too. Oh, Nisha, great ideas. Bean soup, burrito enchiladas, and curries. Wow, Nisha is a really good cook. I know on last Friday's live stream, she was making falafels. So, and she sent me a couple pictures of her recipes. Maybe we need to have her post a few recipes for us, right, Nisha? That would be a lot of fun. Okay, question here from Imperious Gamer. What do I do if squash and tomato seedlings are turning yellow? Okay, there's a lot of different things that can cause yellowing seedlings. You could be watering too much, you could be watering too little, or you could be over-fertilizing. So, you know, what does that tell you? You just kind of don't overlove your plants for sure. But, you know, just kind of troubleshoot and ask yourself if you're doing one of those things. And if you are, back up on the water or give it a little bit more water. Or, you know, just make sure you got your fertilizing down there. Go back and watch our video in the spring garden series, how to water and fertilize your seedlings. That'll give you some really good tips And by the way, guys, I hope you didn't miss our video on Saturday. We planted out all these beautiful vegetables in a really cheap and simple way. And there's Mac. I think he wants to say hello. Mac, can you say hi? We planted out these garden beds on Saturday's video. It just felt so good to get some veggies planted. If you are a brand new gardener, I want to encourage you, you don't need a ton of space. Those two front garden beds have tomatoes, peppers, cucumbers, and squash. So you don't need a ton of space to grow your basic vegetables. I think that first garden bed on the left is a 2.5 by 6. The one on the right is probably a 3 or 4 foot by maybe about a 3 foot. So go back and watch the video for how to get your veggies planted in a cheap and simple way and get something growing. So let's see what other questions are in the chat here. Oh, good question from Lori. Do chives need coolness or heat to germinate? I can't get them to sprout. Okay, they do not need heat. They are more of a cool weather herb. So if you're having a tough time getting them sprouted, it might be that you're trying to germinate them in a spot that's a little bit too warm. So I don't know if you can move them into another area in your house, or if you're trying to germinate them outside, if you can put some shade over them. I believe it was last week I put a picture on my Instagram of some chives, and I actually planted those over the winter last year. So they sprouted during the cooler months here in California. Once it gets 75 or 80, they do tend to turn brown. They will live though, they're a perennial. So mine are getting a little toasted right now in this heat, but you can cut them back and they will come back. The great thing about chives is you can divide them, you can divide the clumps and then maybe plant one clump in the shade where they're not gonna get quite so heated up from the sun. Okay, let's share the third tip here and then we'll have some time to take some more questions. Okay, third tip, and a lot of you were asking this as well, is harvest your beans often. Okay, you want to, once they start to produce, and the clue that they're gonna start producing little beans is of course the flowers. And bean flowers are so pretty. Once the scarlet runner beans behind me start producing flowers, I'll be posting pictures and doing some videos on that. You guys are gonna absolutely love them. In fact, my purple beans over here are already flowering. I'll try and take a picture and post on Instagram at some point this week. But once they are ready to harvest, you want to harvest often. And you're gonna know when they're ready to harvest, when they're probably, like the bush beans should be about the length of your finger or so, maybe a little bit longer, depends on the variety. The scarlet runner beans are probably a little bit longer than that, maybe 6 inches or so, I wouldn't go much more than 6 inches, but harvest them early, harvest them often so they don't get too tough. That way the pods aren't chewy and stringy. But the more you harvest, the more they produce. So you don't want to leave them on the plant till they're overly ripe. You want to harvest them right when the little pod kind of starts to bulge out a little bit. You can see a little shape of the beans in the pod. I don't have a ripe bean yet, so otherwise I would show you guys. But we should have some within maybe 3 to 4 weeks, maybe 3 weeks or so. But harvest them often. When you don't harvest them, it sends a signal to the plant that the plant is done producing and you're not gonna get as many beans out of them. So especially with beans, you have to check them every single day once they start producing. And sometimes they the beans kind of hide underneath the plant, so make sure you kind of pick the plant up, look under the leaves, because the beans do like to hide under there. And that brings up another good point I meant to mention, is even with bush beans, they do benefit if you can put some type of support in them, either the small tomato cages, you can put stakes around your bean container or bean garden bed and string like twine in between them. You can put little stakes around each bean plant. Give them a little bit of support, because once they start producing, they're gonna get heavy and then they kind of tend to fall over. But definitely check to make sure that they, you know, if they need harvesting on a daily basis once they start to mature. Ooh, it's getting toasty out here, even under the umbrella. Okay, so we've got our three tips in for the day, guys. First tip is plant your beans all summer long and you're sure to grow a lot of them. Second tip is water regularly, but don't over-fertilize. They're not like tomatoes and peppers that need regular fertilizing. And the third tip is harvest often. Make sure that you check your beans to see if they need harvesting once they start to produce. Check them every single day. All right, let's see what questions we have in the chat. I'm sure you guys have a lot of bean questions or maybe other gardening questions. Before we do that though, I wanted to mention something. When this whole coronavirus thing started, It was really encouraging to see so many of you that were helping out your friends and neighbors, encouraging people, bringing harvest over, and really helping people learn how to grow, which we all know it helps our mental health. So we haven't talked about that for a couple of weeks, but I would also love to hear in the chat today if any of you have any inspiring stories of either someone helping you get through maybe a tough day or a tough time, maybe how your garden has helped you, or maybe how you've been able to help other people. Because it's really easy to become, you know, focused on yourself and, oh, I'm feeling so sad, I'm feeling so down, I'm feeling so anxious. But there's always someone that has it worse than you do, or is feeling worse than you do, or is in a worse situation. So when you help other people and reach out to other people, that really helps uplift your mood and gives you that satisfaction that you're serving someone else, you're helping someone else, and you're helping make their day better. So I'd really love to hear from anyone if you have had that experience this week. Okay, questions, comments in the chat. Hear from Schaefer. Do we need to soak our beans overnight before planting? No, you do not need to soak your beans. They germinate so quickly. If the weather is right, if it's between 60 and 85 degrees, you're gonna see them sprout so quick, you do not need to soak them. They'll probably sprout within a couple of days. I think these little bean plants probably sprouted in maybe 2 to 3 days. They were in my grow closet where it was pretty darn warm in there. It's probably around 75 or 80, maybe even warmer, and they have grown so, so fast. So no, you don't need to soak them. If you're planting them outside, here's one thing I wanted to mention. If you plant them when it's cold outside, I planted the beans I showed you earlier in the live stream when it was probably still in the 40s at night and probably in the 60s, maybe even 50s during the day. They grew very, very slowly at first because it wasn't the right temperature. So, you know, it was okay. I was trying to plant them early and experimenting with that, which is fine, but don't expect them to grow quickly if you're still experiencing cold temperatures in the evenings. Okay. Watching this live chat as I'm making masks. That's great. That's one way you can really help people. Yes, Denise, you can put them directly in the soil, start them indoors, containers or garden beds. We covered that earlier in the video, so you might want to go back and watch the replay when we're done here. Just seeded some edamame and chickpeas yesterday. There's so many different varieties. That's great, Robin. You're able to find a lot. Yeah, let me know too what varieties you like. There are just a million different kinds out there. Keith, how are you, Keith? Your videos really helped me take my mind off of the depression. Thank you so much, Keith. I know you mentioned that in the Friday live stream too, so I'm so glad to hear that. And focus on good things like growing things. Thank you so much, Kim. You're so welcome, Keith. Our pleasure, and I'm really sorry that you're struggling with depression. I know a lot of people are struggling with that right now. Thank you for sharing that and being brave enough to share that. And I'm glad that gardening has helped. It can really help clear your mind, give you mental clarity, and you get a lot of exercise, and it just feels so good knowing that you're growing something, and it's so much fun to check on your garden every day. Okay, Tommy Daly, how are you, Tommy? Do we SoCal folks need heating pads on our indoor seeds? Okay, good question, Tommy. The only seed, especially at this time of the year, that you really need a heating pad for is peppers. All other warm weather vegetables will germinate fine without a heating mat, and beans do not need a heating mat. Definitely your cool weather vegetables do not need a heating mat. It'll make it too warm for them to germinate. I pretty much use a heating mat for peppers to germinate any time of the year, but I know a lot of people do it without a heating mat as well, especially when the weather is warm like it is now. So just experiment and see what works best for you. But yes, definitely on the peppers, but no, pretty much on everything else. Okay, Laura. Hi, Laura from New York. Love rattlesnake beans. Trying a few new ones like Tar Heel. Have you ever grown it? No, I've never grown rattlesnake beans. That would be a really fun one to try. I've heard about them, so I may have to try and look for some seeds for rattlesnake beans because those are pretty cool. Also, those long, yard-long beans. I'm gonna have to get myself some seeds for that. So let me know here in the chat if you've tried those. Those look really, really fun to grow as well. And I think you probably need a big space for those. So maybe I'll have to stick some back here on the cattle panel. Okay, Cliff, thank you so much. This group really makes my day. I totally agree with that. We need some cheer these days. Yeah, it's really fun to come here. Thanks, Cliff, to come here on Mondays and see so many people in the chat here. just the positivity that's going around, a lot of people encouraging each other and being positive and helpful to one another. So it really gives us something to look forward to on those days where it might seem like a really long day. So glad that you guys are here. And also make sure you join us for the Friday Fireside live streams as well, where Camera Guy jumps on, and it's usually more of a casual time, but I would love to see a lot of you on there as well. And we pretty much just go through the chat and answer questions. So if you have garden questions, that's a really good time to get them answered. Because we are so busy right now, because gardening is at such a high interest, I just don't have time to answer a lot of email questions. So I'm so sorry if I've not been able to get back to you. But the best way to get your question answered is to jump on the live stream either on Mondays at noon or Fridays at 5:30 p.m. Pacific time and ask it there. Or just search the topic that you want to know on our YouTube channel, and we're bound to have a video on it. And people will answer your questions here in the chat as well. It's one great thing about this community. Abdahu Kim, I'm so sorry I didn't say your name right, but you are watching from Sweden. That's awesome. I'm so glad you're watching. What a fun thing to watch from Sweden and have you, you know, halfway across the world. I don't grow anything, but I find peace for my soul. Wonderful. Glad I found your channel. Thank you. Thank you so much. I appreciate it. And hopefully you will be able to grow something. Even a little pot of lettuce is a great way to grow. I know Sweden is a whole lot cooler than California, so maybe you can grow some lettuce in a container, either indoors or outside. Okay, I think I saw another super chat scroll by. Cliff, can you verify that? I'm not sure where it went. Let me scroll down. Oh, here we are from Lumberjacks, $5. Thank you so much, Lumberjacks. I appreciate that. Thank you so much for being here today. I really appreciate your support. Okay, my mint is blowing up from Tommy. Don't know how to harvest. Okay, mint grows crazy right now, Tommy. My mint's growing nuts too in the warm weather. So easy to harvest. You wanna just snip, I think I've got a video on that. I'm sure, yeah, I think I filmed one last year. I probably have a couple. So search mint, you'll find a couple videos. I just clip off a couple of branches or stems from my mint plant whenever I want to harvest it, and it will grow back so fast. And I hope, Tommy, you're growing mint in a container, because it does tend to be quite invasive. So hopefully you've got it in a container, are able to snip it and enjoy it in water, enjoy some tea, enjoy it in drinks. It's such a versatile and delicious herb to grow. Okay, Beauty by Greg. How do you eat those scarlet runners? Just eat the lids and all, or use as a dry bean? And I like how you call them lids. That's pretty funny. The answer is both. You want to harvest them when they're about 6 inches to eat them for the beans themselves. They do tend to get tough, and the pods get very stringy if they're over 6 inches or so long. Once they get big, though, you can open up the pod, take the bean out, and leave it to dry for a couple days. I should have brought it out here with me. I totally forgot. A whole jar that I dried from last year. You can either replant them or then make like refried beans out of them. You can, you know, boil them till they get soft. And I haven't tried mine yet, but from what I've heard, they're very delicious. Okay, let's see here. Yes, Roland, good therapy for the lockdown. Absolutely. Okay, let's see here. Question from Rosario. Beginner question. Soil, no dumb questions here. We love beginner questions too. Soil is splitting in container. Did I not put in enough soil? How do I fix it? It's just sprouting. Soil is splitting. It could be that it's too dry. If you're kind of getting those split things in a container, it could be too dry. You might need to kind of tamp it down just a little bit, but if it's wet enough and it's moist enough, then you should be okay. I move my containers around a lot, so sometimes my soil does kind of break apart, which is really no big deal. But you do want to be careful if you have seeds that are germinating, because it could disturb the little seedlings if you're moving your containers a lot. So maybe just let it sit. You do want to fill your containers up as much as you can. And by the way, that's one thing I love about the smart pots, is that they help you save on soil, because you can fold the sides of the container down. So you can see my little container here. Got some beautiful kale, is about 2 to 3 inches from the top, and then if I want to only fill it half full, I could, and then just fold the sides down, depending on the vegetable that you're growing, depending on the depth that you might need for that particular vegetable. Oh, and I forgot to mention, guys, The smart pots sold out so fast last week on my website, the Calichem smart pots. I can't remember if I mentioned that in the beginning of the video or not. They are going to be back in stock tomorrow. So check my website, calichemgardenandhome.com, for the 5 gallons or the purple Calichem smart pots, which have about 3 feet of growing space. Actually, those will not be in stock probably for at least another week, but the 5 gallons will be back in stock tomorrow. So check tomorrow. But if you want them, buy them fast because they sell out within a couple of days. And smart pots is just so backed up. They have so many orders. It takes me probably at least a week or maybe more to get them back in stock. So if you want them, check tomorrow. Again, I am not able to respond to emails for people asking when are they going to be back in stock. I could literally spend all day on emails lately, and I want to get the seeds to you and create content as fast as we possibly can. So just check back. I'll try and let you know on Instagram and here on the live streams when they'll be back in stock so that you guys know. All right. Do I add soil to the outside from Rosario again here? Do I add soil to the outside of the Calichem smart pot? No, you don't. You just need to add it to the inside and grow your vegetables inside. You can place those smart pots on any kind of surface, dirt, cement, a deck, whatever you want, and they will grow anything. You can grow anything in them as long as you have a big enough container. Okay, we'll take a couple more questions before we sign off for the day. Wonderful to see so many people here today, and I'm so glad you guys took time out of your day to join me. Okay, let's see if we have any more comments. How to handle aphids on nasturtiums from Miriam. Okay, the one thing about nasturtiums, they do tend to, like, to keep aphids off your vegetables. The good thing is, one thing you can do is plant, it's called a trap crop, and nasturtiums can be that because they will attract other bugs that you don't necessarily want to be on your vegetables. You know, unless you're going to eat a lot of your nasturtiums, I wouldn't worry about it too much. But what you can do to rinse off the aphids, to get rid of aphids, is pretty much what you do for aphids on anything. I would spray it with some water to rinse off the aphids, and then I would use neem oil and peppermint oil to help control the chewing insects like aphids. And you can go and watch the video on that on our YouTube channel. Okay, one or two more questions. Let's see. From Ollie, watching from Germany. Last year, all my balcony beans died from some rusty leaf disease. Any idea how to prevent it this year? Ollie, I'm not too familiar with how to prevent that in beans. If anyone else has any ideas on that, I would love to hear in the chat. So again, one great thing about having so many gardeners is that someone knows how to do just about anything here, and we can all help each other out. Okay, Florida Homestead. Hi, how are you? First year gardener from Florida. Awesome. I've been told I can only grow lima beans and watermelon through the summer. What else do you recommend to help plants last through the hot summer? Okay, couple videos we have on that we just posted a few weeks ago, early heat wave. The key thing is called shade cloth. So go back and check out those videos. You're going to need a lot of shade cloth there in Florida because it's hot all summer long. So check those videos out, and the shade cloth will really, really help. Okay, question here from Andrea. I've only direct sown beans, never started them inside. Can you start all types and varieties? Absolutely, you sure can. You can start just about any type of bean indoors. The key thing with that, though, is don't start them too early. You only need to start them indoors about 2 weeks before your last frost date. If you start them too soon, because they grow so fast, they're going to outgrow their containers. And these, I could have even started these, I wanted to have these ready in time for this container garden series, but I'm going to start some more because they're already outgrowing these little containers here. And our series probably won't start for about 2 more weeks. So I'm going to start some more today. And just in case something happens to these. But yeah, you can start pretty much any type of bean indoors. You do want to be careful when you're transplanting because they don't like to have their roots disturbed. So I always do both. Again, I plant beans all season long, start them indoors, and then plant them outside directly in the garden beds once it gets warm enough outside, and they're going to be so easy to grow. Okay, question from Keith. I don't have a garden. I'm just growing in my small apartment. And that's great, Keith. I have a fungus gnat problem and neem oil isn't helping. Also tried cinnamon and sticky traps, but every time I water, I see them. Okay. Sometimes the fungus gnats, there's a lot of different things you can do, but the biggest key is you got to get it before they get out of control. If they get out of control, they're very hard to control indoors because there's no natural predators inside. So you're doing all the right things. You got your neem oil, you've got your sticky traps, the cinnamon. One thing I found that I think works better than just about anything is apple cider vinegar in little bottle caps with a drop or two of dish soap. You can even use like white wine or red wine, but apple cider vinegar is readily available. They're attracted to that. They kind of, you know, start to drink it, they fall in, they die, and that really does help. But the next time you plant, make sure that you do preventative measures, like just go ahead and put those little apple cider vinegar bottle caps up, even if you don't see the fungus gnats, and that way you're avoiding the issue before it even starts. You know, a lot of people say, oh, the neem oil doesn't work or whatever doesn't work. Well, that's because there's no natural predators inside, and when it gets out of control, it's, you know, it's really hard to you know, get it back under control. So try that, and then let me know, Keith, if that helps. Okay, guys, this has been a ton of fun. It's great to see 850 people by my screen here on today. So many people gardening. I'm so happy that all of you are growing your own food. And let me know what you're growing, what you're planting. Make sure you follow me on Instagram on CaliKim29. And also Camera Guy is CaliCameraGuy over on Instagram. So make sure you follow him as well. He always posts some really fun video or fun photos of kind of behind the scenes. And once he goes back to work, you're going to want to see his videos and pictures he takes at work, because they're always really interesting. He works for one of the studios here in LA. All right, guys, have a great week. We will see you on Friday Fireside at 5:30 and next Monday at noon Pacific time, and a video or two in between. Thanks so much. We'll see you later. And don't forget the Mother's Day Spring Garden Book Seed Bundle order today. All right, guys, have a great week. Bye-bye.